from state to state, I've run into attorney generals who have more power and the ability to make direct impact in everywhere from holding people accountable to pursuing policies that keep people safe so that there's no one to be held accountable. Those power lines run through that attorney general office, and I think there should be someone in that office that actually represents people.
So Lee Merritt, you are moving your shingle to the voting booth of sorts, trying to get Texans to vote for you to be the attorney general in that state. Why are you running for office and why Texas?
We've taken on so many fights in Texas for the past, about 8 years of my practice. We fought police brutality. Texas leads the country in uses of force. It vies between California and Texas. It's the most incarcerated state in our country. And so as we take on these issues, I've had to butt heads with our elected officials, denying evidence. You know, these videos that we've seen leaked out to media or that we've been able to capture through our investigations, those should be something that is available to the public. There are urgency on issues that impact my clients, that impact my community, everywhere from voting rights to property taxes in Texas. The role and responsibility of the Attorney General in Texas is to advise the governor on legal strategy, on what is constitutional. HB 7, the Texas voter suppression law, is unconstitutional. It's not going to survive constitutional muster. There should be advocates, and that impacts, by the way, that impacts all my cases. That impacts all my clients. I'm not running despite all my cases. I'm running because of it. From state to state, I've run into attorney generals who have more power and the ability to make direct impact in everywhere from holding people accountable to pursuing policies that keep people safe so that there's no one to be held accountable. Those power lines run through that attorney general office, and I think there should be someone in that office that actually represents people. Their current leadership in Texas is not serving either party. They're serving themselves. Ken Paxton has spent more litigation time dealing with Trump's agenda, the suing over a feckless suit, quite frankly, that was never going to work about the election. The Governor Abbott has focused his attention, including the state's police officers, to a border crisis that he's actually aggravating as opposed to resolving and helping Texans. And I think that people are tired of seeing their resources squandered. I think there's more commonality in our movement than people think. My brand has never been left or right or Democrat or Republican. My brand has always been people-centered. I think we can do better as a community. And, it's going to be a tough sell because you're right. No Democrat has ever won statewide office in Texas, and so I'm hoping to reach a brand of people and more importantly, inspire a brand of people to come out and participate in the process that probably haven't in the past. And I hope we can do that by telling them that, this is our takeover. This is not my campaign. This is our campaign. This is a people's campaign.